Well, I'm really delighted. I mean, it's a one-off drama, the first acting part that I'd actually taken for a very long time. I loved the script. It was an angle on war that I'd never seen before, which is, you know, how people get through the suffering by, you know, humour. And so it kind of related to me, and I'm very, very chuffed for them. I think it was a brilliant script and very well played by others than myself. I'm the luckiest extra in the business on this one. Yeah, I mean, I've never really stopped acting. You kind of you use it even when you're doing travel programs and all that. I was a little nervous of doing this, but then, you know, we've done Python characters, generals, army characters before. Since then, I've actually been played a lead in a new BBC series called Remember Me, which is going to be out in the autumn, I think. It was shot in Yorkshire. So I'm enjoying doing a bit more showing off, as I call it, acting, as some people call it.
Talking about Python, we're so excited for the summer and the reunion shows. How does it feel for you to be back working with the guys, and is there going to be new material or is it going to be the old favourites?
Old favourites, basically, because I think people would sort of stone us if we didn't actually do Dead Parrot and things like that. How it'll work out, I don't know. I mean, we really won't know until the first night at the O2. We'll prepare. We've got quite a big show. It's kind of big production values, dances and all that sort of thing. So it won't be just old blokes on either side of a desk trying to remember their lines. It will be quite a good evening. And, I mean, the magic will happen or not happen on the 1st of July.
Of course, I mean, the show sold out so quickly. I think it demonstrated just how much of an appetite there is to see you guys perform together. Do you think that there's any chance that this might lead to more film work or more television work? Or is this just what it is and it's going to be what it is?
I think this is what it is. We were really going to do one show with maybe a couple of others, just to, you know, put some money into the Python coffers. We were all amazed by the actual degree of enthusiasm, the fact it sold out in 43 seconds, the first one and all that. But we, I think, quite sensibly said, let's do 10. In the end, we did 10 shows, quite a lot more than we expected. Make the last show, which is on the 20th of July, a really big show, Python's last show together. And I think it probably may well be. There are no plans beyond that. Let's just get these 10 done really well, and we'll take it from there.
Is there one sketch in particular that you're personally most excited to be performing yet again?
Well, I'm quite pleased to be having a go at Spanish Inquisition, because we've never done it on stage. Most of the others we've had a go at. It'll be the first time we've done Spanish Inquisition, and it's an extremely silly sketch, and so I'm quite looking forward to seeing how that goes.
Most recently, you were in Brazil. I know you talked to Mr. Carl Pilkington about his own experiences travelling.
I did, yes.
I wondered how you found that experience.
Yeah, well, Carl's a very funny guy, but he's funny in a kind of quite different way to me. He just says everything's miserable and wretched and awful out there. Whereas I go on about, oh, it's so wonderful, the world's a wonderful place. So we're a bit yin and yang, but I liked him. He's very funny. And, I think he must like travelling more than he ever appears to do, or he wouldn't do so many of these series. And I think that's a great thing. People travel in different ways. They get different things out of them. Carl gets one thing, I get another.